Alicia is 20 years old. She is currently a third-year law student at Universitas Gadjah Mada, the number one university in Indonesia. You may now ask her questions.
Okay, I'll be the first. So one of the biggest problems in Indonesia is deforestation.
Yes.
And the conversion of a lot of lands to palm oil plantations, and to that extent, the gorillas are affected, and a lot of biodiversity are affected. What is your view on this kind of industry?
On the palm oil industry, if I may ask for clarification. Yes, in my opinion, in regards to deforestation itself, it is definitely a huge prominent issue, and one of the main causes of deforestation is in fact the palm oil industry. However, in my opinion, aside from the palm oil industry itself, there are a lot of other issues or causes that have to be mitigated along with palm oil industry. And in my opinion, the way that we tackle this is in fact through the government and the law enforcement, because the source of it is through the law enforcement and concrete action and care from the government towards deforestation and the palm oil industry. Therefore, it must be mitigated and also find other issues for the locals to find the income and other for the other economic industries for it to prosper.
Terima kasih.
I've asked this question earlier, but I want to pick your brain a bit. If someone were to give you a choice, what would you choose as a gift? A bicycle or a car?
Well, I think put in the environmental context, of course, a bicycle. And in my opinion, the reason why I choose bicycle is because it helps promote the environmental awareness. And aside from promotion, it is a way for me myself to implement the 5 R's and also be a good role model for the students or for children and for others to see. However, aside from the bicycle, it also has to have support from, you know, the country itself, from the infrastructure. But in Indonesia, a way to tackle this issue is by being one of the first to use the bicycle. And here I would definitely choose the bicycle over the car, because it does prove to be a means of the 5 R's or the implementation of the 5 R's. Thank you.
We're the two archipelagic countries of Southeast Asia, the Philippines and Indonesia. What would you say are the shared cultural values perhaps that our people would have?
Well, seeing from personal experience being here, my stay here for 3 weeks in the Philippines, and a bit of research prior to coming here in the Philippines, I see that there are several similarities in the historical context, in the physical context, even in the language, the culture. Historically, we were once part of the Malay, and that's why I guess a lot of similarities. But aside from that, the language as well, because say for example, the languages like Mata, Bibir, Hidung, very similar, and also the food and the culture. When it comes to our cultural similarities, it's abundant. But of course, even in the environmental issues, it is also very prominent that there are similarities because of the similarities in the environment and our, in the environment itself, but also the issues because of, you know, Indonesia's transboundary pollution, say for example. So a lot of similarities between the two countries and archipelago states.
Did you bring a sample of your poo paper with you that you show in your eco video?
Unfortunately, I did not bring. However, it is actually, if I'm not mistaken, there is also in Thailand. So it's starting to expound, yeah. But it's actually newly established in Indonesia. So if you do come to Indonesia, then maybe I can show it to you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for your time.
What paper? Pool paper.
Thank you very much, Miss Indonesia.